Thank you very much. We are very happy to welcome you, President Zelensky, to the Philippines. And I'm very happy that despite what I know is a very tight travel schedule, for both of us, we were unable to find the time while we were both in Singapore. But I'm happy that we are very honored that you found the time to pass by the Philippines. I know that the crisis in your country has occupied all of your attention and all of your time, and it is a great pleasure to meet with you to discuss some of the issues that are common to our two countries, and hopefully find ways forward for both of us together. And but once again, I wish it were under better circumstances, but I am happy that you are able to come and visit with us, Mr. President.
Thank you so much, Mr. President. Your team, we are very happy to be first time in Philippines. I'm sure not last. Thank you for this invitation, and we are very thankful to be in your country, and which supports Ukraine, our territorial integrity and sovereignty. Thank you so much for your big word and clear position about us, about this Russian occupation of our territories, and thank you on your support on the in UN Nations with your resolutions. Mr. President, I'm happy to hear today from you that you participate our peace steps to the peace, that real thing, what really want our people, just to bring peace to our homes. Thank you for participation of peace summit. That's very strong signal. Like I said, we have for today more than 100 countries. I think it will be maybe not the last again, but the first very strong step on the way to peace. Nice. And I'm also very happy that this year we will open embassy in Manila. That's very good decision.
That's certainly very good news, because we would very much like to continue to help in any way that the Philippines can, through the multilateral, the United Nations, and even through other agencies such as the EU, such as the UN, and so we will continue to do all that we can to promote peace and to bring an end to the fighting.